أشراف مطلب وطالبه لله أكرام من يمشي على قدم. العلم نور مبين يستضيء به أهل السعادات والجهال في الظلم.
طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد. So just shallow use up just some of the time inshallah ta'ala that we have. By the way, you know, we're going to have an exam, you know, inshallah ta'ala. Nah, alhamdulillah. More exams after, Or we'll just go to Surah Quraysh now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. First of all, how comes I'm saying A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim now? Didn't I say it before? We can remember the rulings. I already started reciting though. Before, wasn't I reciting before? Ah, good. Because of a disconnect. The ulama, they're mentioning the person gets disconnected, even though you still may have the mushaf in your hand. You're sitting there, you get disconnected for a long period or a relatively long amount period, and then you start chatting, doing this, doing that, so that your whole mind is completely off to focus on what you're doing. Then you want to come back and read, you have to start with A'udhu Billah again. Otherwise, if it's just maybe you look right, look left, chat to someone for a bit, say something, maybe go somewhere to quickly come back with intent and continuing, then you just continue and say Bismillah. So Allah said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Lila fi Quraysh, Ila fihim rihlat al-shita'i wa-s-sayif, fali'abudu rabba hadha al-bayt, alladhi at'amahum min ju'in wa-amanahum. So السعدي mentions it. This قال كثير من المفسرين إن الجار والمجرور متعلق بالسورة التي قبلها, which is very interesting. That the jar and the مجرور, okay, the jar and مجرور is something that you learn inshallah ta'ala in grammar, but it's a particle that's used sometimes to join things such as, even in the English language, perhaps particles such as fi, to, from, okay, and stuff like that. Here, the Mufassirun, they said that it is mentioned, is mutalaqun bi surat qabla, is connected to the surah before it. So if we go to the surah before it, فَجَعَلَهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ لِإِلَى فِي قُرَيْشٍ. Okay, so As-Si'di said he's connected to that. A, meaning, فَعَلْنَا مَا فَعَلْنَا بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ, meaning we've done what we've done with أصحاب الفيل لأجل قريش, لإيلاف قريش, for قريش, وأمنهم واستقامة مصالحهم, for their peace. So Allah says فَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ كَعَصْفٍ مَأْكُولٍ in Surah Al-Fil. So we made them like stalk or straw, ma'chud, like straws chewed, li'ilafi Quraysh. Li is harfu jar, for, and it means for the success of Quraysh, because that's who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved. He saved them. And by the way, I didn't mention, but when the elephants were coming, they left, the Quraysh left the whole area, they left the whole Mecca, because they knew they couldn't deal with this army. So they just were bystanders and they saw this whole thing happening. Yet still, they became disbelievers and mushrikeen. They were still mushrikun. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he says, فَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, they would not believe, some disbelievers would never believe, حَتَّى يَرَوُ الْعَذَابَ الْعَلِيمِ, until they see the pain, until they see the punishment. Quite frank there. So this harf jar is mutalliqan, is connected to the surah before it. So the Quraysh, so now Allah Azza wa Jal is saying he set the stone for the Quraysh to be in his prosperity. Ilafihim, where, which prosperity? Ilafihim, their prosperity, rihlat al-shita'i was safe. Their rihla, and rihla is the journey. of الشتاء والصيف during the شتاء during winters and summers. Because there are highway robbers traveling at those times. Even traveling now, you can be succumb to scammers, stalkers, especially for women. Some women, they get followed all the way to their apartments. Some men, أعوذ بالله, who don't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and don't have haya, they will stalk some women from the airport, lone women who are traveling, or even if they're in groups. Men, some men don't care, because of a group of women to one man is nothing. And they follow them all the way up until the many times. This is the known fact. So some sisters, there may be, أعوذ بالله, shaitan has come and he's given them the khida, the lie, trickery, and the deception, tilbis iblis. And he tells them, today the airports are full of people, it's full of yani cameras. This is not like the time of the Sahaba. La wallah. With some men, they come to the airport, they know, because the people of the land, they know who are foreigners and who are not. And they've seen many like you that come and go for your little holiday to your little luxury apartment and villas. So they, the least that would be done to you is that you get robbed. Because you're harmless, you're a woman who's not stronger than a man. She goes to you straight, they'll rob you. Most likely you're carrying a lot of money, or if not, exchange. And worse, they follow them to their apartment, stalk them and pounce on them at the right time. Predators. So still, the illa may not be there, or if even if it's not there, meaning it still is there, but even if the illa, which is the reason, yani for the safety of the women, that she shouldn't travel without a mahram, still, it's still the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is sunnah qa'ima, that doesn't change. So here, rihlat al-shita, Allah made it safe for the Quraysh to be traveling. No, how, yani, they weren't fearing this, yani, this onslaught. So for that reason, fa, this is a fa al-sababiyya, the fact of reason, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا, then let them worship رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ, the Lord of this bait, this house. So this fa مُتَعَلِّقٌ بِمَا قَلْهَا, this fa huna is the fa that is connected to what came before it. So because Allah Azza wa Jal has done that for you, then let them worship رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ, meaning not the idols in there, because the Quraysh were pagans. So Allah Azza wa Jal said, look, we saved Al-Fil. We mentioned Aam Al-Fil was the year the Prophet ﷺ was born, right? He saved them. And that's why Ibn Kathir, he mentions in his tafsir, in the ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, and he says, Ya ayyuha al-ladhin, ya ayyuha al-nas u'budu rabbakum, al-ladhi khalaqakum. والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء. On and on, that Allah mentions the things that He's given, so that he could, Ibn Kathir, he said, الخالق لهذه الأشياء هو المستحق للعبادة, the one who created all of these things is deserving of being worshipped. So the one who saved them لإلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا, so let them worship. بسبب هذا الدليل على استحقاق العبادة لله, because that was the خصومة. The opposition wasn't rububiyya, acknowledgement of Allah, as many people try to make it out. Some of the أهل البدعة, they make it seem like توحيد is that alone, so they can pave the way for their grave worship, such as the Sufis and the like. But rather the khasm, the opposition to the prophets, was the ibadah and the mafhum al-ibadah. فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ. And again, Allah Azza wa Jal is saying رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. So he says, الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ, the one who's fed them من جُوعٍ, from hunger, وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ, and secured them from fear. So which one is worse, ikhwan? Al-ju' or al-khawf? You say hunger? What do you say? Someone says khawf, you say khawf. What about you? Khawf. Khawf is the correct answer. Ibn Uthaymeen mentions this in his Sharh or Riyadh al-Salihin under the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ. Then Allah says, وَالْجُوعِ. Of hunger. Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ. Surah Al-Baqarah. I don't know the exact ayah, but Allah Azza wa Jalla says he's going to trial you of something from, and he mentions the trial but starts off with fear. Ibn Uthaymeen mentions in his Sharh Riyadh al-Salihin, in the chapter of patience, he said, why did Allah start with fear before hunger? He says, because fear is worse than hunger. Why? Because if a person's hungry, but they don't fear nothing, he said they can go and find تبحث عن الطعام حتى ولو حصلوا يعني حشاش الأرض. Even if they were to find like insects on the floor or something, they'll still eat it. You can find, hunt, you can still find something to eat because there's no fear. But when you are in fear, he said they'll close the doors behind them. Well, he never said this, but summary, the person would stay in their homes and they would be out there. For example, if a war's kicked off right on your doorstep, bombs, armies faced off, standoff right in front of your home, you can't leave. If you leave, you risk death, immediate death. Okay, a drone would spot, for example, a person, especially in this modern warfare that we live in. Fear. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is alluding to some of the things that He's taken away from them. If they do, so Allah ordered them for what? Ibadah. This ayah, these two ayahs combined, they remind us of another ayah where Allah promised the believers. Surah An-Nur. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم وليبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا. Why? يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا. Because of إقامة العبادة لله. توحيد, توحيد. So Allah says فليعبدوا, let them يعبدوا, worship هذا البيت, رب هذا البيت. The one who at'amahum min ju', fed them and quenched them of hunger or thirst, repelled them of hunger and secured them from fear. So Allah says, وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ بِمْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا. Allah has promised the believers who do righteous deeds that Allah would يَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ, give them succession in the land. كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. The مِنْ قَبْلِ. That's what Allah has said, like those who came before. Okay, and as Musa alayhi salam, he says that al-ardu lillah yurithuha man yasha, the earth is for Allah, he gives it to whoever he wants from min ibadihi, of his servants. And then Allah azza wa jal, he mentioned in the Zabur, أن الأرض يرثها عبادي الصالحون, that the earth, those who would inherit it, are the righteous عباد. So this is a direct understanding of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah on how to make yourself secure is to worship Allah. فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وأمنهم من خوف. Meaning مفهوم المخالفة is that if they don't worship the Lord of the Kaaba, then Allah will bring about khawf and jur. And Allah mentioned this as well. Allah says, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ number one, آمِنَةً. Look at that. Allah's bringing safety first. We said khawf is the worst, right? Allah says, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً. Allah gives you an example of a town. كانت it used to be آمنة, having safety and security. No beseeching or breaking of its boundaries and its borders. كانت آمنة مطمئنة يأتيها رزقها رغدا من كل مكان فكفرت بأنعم الله فأذاقها الله. So Allah said that you used to come to this town, its produce from every direction. فكفرت, and he disbelieved in the أنعم الله, in the bounties of Allah. فأذاقها الله. So Allah done مفهوم المخ, Allah done taking away of the blessings. فأذاقها الله لباس الجوع والخوف. Allah gave them a جوع, hunger and خوف. That's why الأمن, أمن يا إخوة, my brothers, الأمن والأمن. When the Khawarij or the people who wanted to revolt against rulers came to Imam Ahmad, Imam Ahmad, he said الدماء, الدماء, blood, blood, blood. It's very secure, very important. Because without أمن and safety and security, هدم الدين والدنيا, the destruction of deen and dunya. Person, now if you look, some of the Syrians, for example, may Allah Azza wa Jal save them and grant them good, and the rest of this ummah, due to the misguidance of the Khawarij, namely the Ikhwan al-Muslimin, and that which they made, or that which they encouraged them to do, of going against the rules when they didn't have ability, and then the destruction and the division came, and the hunger, now they're in refugee camps, some of them are selling their deens and their selves. It's reported that some of our sisters, وَلِعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ, are forced to, أعوذ بالله, commit things for food and hunger and shelter, or for quote unquote a better life. And the blood of the Muslim now has become cheap. So that Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned this, وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. Allah said, this nation, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرِيَةً, a town. This town, the ulama, they mentioned in the tafsir, this was Mecca. Look at this, I see how it's all connected. Allah saved them from Fil, Ashab al-Fil, who tried to destroy them. Allah gave them everything. That's why Allah said, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرِيَةً. Allah gives you an example of a qariya, كانت آمِنَةً, used to be in safety. And this Allah's talking about the qariya, the Mufassirin, they mention is Makkah. أُمُّ الْقُرَى وَلِتُنْذِرَ أُمُّ الْقُرَى وَلِتُنْذِرَ أُمُّ الْقُرَى أُمَّ الْقُرَى. So that you can warn أُمَّ الْقُرَى. They were the people of the town. So when they disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says, فَأَذَاقَهُ اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ. Allah gave them الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ. Why? They didn't listen to Allah when he said, فَلِيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتَ الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَأَمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. He saved them from hunger. And so مفهوم المخالفة is that if you don't do that, this would happen, as it happened to Quraysh. As Allah said, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرِيَةً. Allah gives you an example of a qariya. It is said that Mecca used to have good produce, good agriculture at a time. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took it off them. Others, they mention this happened, that Allah Azza wa Jal taking and putting them in hunger and fear. This happened when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gained dominance. That the Prophet beseeched and done a I forgot what it was called in military terms or war terms. You know, when you stand outside like a castle or fortress, siege, that's it. There was a siege. Some of the ulama, they mentioned Mufassirin, this ayah, ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرِيَةً كَانَتْ, a town that used to be upon خير, it's producing, and then Allah swept it with fear and hunger. They said the Prophet sieged them just before taking over the market. The Prophet sieged them and he stopped anything going in there, so they had hunger for a while. This is some of the tafsir that was given for this ayah. So Allah is saying, إِلَى, all of that was إِلَى فِي قُرَيْش, for the success of Quraysh. إِلَى فِيهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَصَيْفِ. So when you see the kufr and the inad, the stubbornness of Quraysh, Allahu Akbar. And then you see the punishment that follows, Allah Azza wa Jalla, وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ. Allah is not oppressive to us, to his abid. And al-amn, safety, my brothers, is just two types. There's the safety that a person has in his deen. No shubuhat. So a person should flee from الزيغ والانحراف والكفر and بدعة والمنكرات innovations and wrongdoing and oppression and then there's the safety of actual abdan the body the one where now you fear a war just like they feared the elephant That's why Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah he mentioned just in regards to giving thanks to Allah for the safety and the fact that Allah had gave them tamakkun as Allah says wa'ada Allahu alladhina amanu wa 'amilu salihat Allah said Allah has guaranteed those who believe and do righteous deeds that he will make them successors to the land Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah mentions as reported by many of his talamid such as Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawzi that بالأمن بالصبر واليقين تنال الإمامة في الدين with صبر and يقين certainty a person can reach الإمامة في الدين can reach leadership and the pinnacles of being able to govern although a person doesn't seek it but it means that dominance will be brought about by what الصبر واليقين patience and يقين أي عقيدة the correct عقيدة by being patient, such as Musa said, when Musa, when the people of Musa were surrounded by Pharaoh and his people, they said to him, "Yani, what are we going to do?" He said, "Ya qawm," he said, "Oh my people, isbiru, be patient. Inna al-arda lillahi yurithuha min yasha. The earth is for Allah and He gives it to whoever He wants." So a shukr, Allah is calling, ordering them to do a shukr. فَأَبَوْا They, Al-Quraysh, and anyone who follows this, they didn't want to take the shukr. And that's why, know that whenever Allah's ni'mah comes and people don't give shukr, the ni'mah turns into niqmah. And this is from the qa'ida of al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. The qa'ida which is al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. That the reward or the recompense is similar to the essence of the action. As Allah said, hal jaza'u al-ihsani illa al-ihsan. Is there any reward for good except good? Allah Azza wa Jalla said that Allah has made for them ghuraf, rooms, and mentions descriptions of paradise, bima sabaru, because of their patience. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, فَانْصَرَفُوا صَرَفَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ They turned away, so Allah turned their hearts. جزاء من جنس العمل. The recompense is like for like. As they say, كَمَا تُدِين تُدَان If you do like you do, it will be done to you. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ They forgot Allah, so Allah forgot them. Yani, not that Allah forgives, it's not sifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But here it means that Allah made them to be forgotten. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْ يُهُ بَلِيبْ And then Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ Don't be those who forgot Allah, so Allah made them to forget themselves. So the point is, أَلْجَزَاءُ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ So here, they were safe from the field. Allah said, worship the one who أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَأَمَنُهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ Fed them, quenched, yani, relieved them from hunger, and saved them from fear. Then Allah says, because they didn't do that, Rasul came, they belied the Rasul. ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً Look, they used to be آمِنَة. مُطْمَئِنَّة. يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا Risk used to come. Used to flow in. فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ They disbelieved in the blessings of Allah. فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ So Allah did what? got rid of that. And that's why the Prophet used to say in the dua, oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from fuja niqmatak, from the sudden punishments and catastrophe. And he says, وَتَحَوَّلُ نِعْمَتَكَ, and that you change and get rid of your blessings. Because if a blessing is not given its due right, which is the shukr that it deserves in tongue and in action. اِعْمَلُوا عَلَى دَاوُدَ شُكْرًا. Do, O people of Dawood, shukr. Shukr is an action as well. Person doesn't just say Alhamdulillah and then continues to do batil. La, you use it in the right way. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal said, going back to Al-Amn and how important it is, Allah Azza wa Jal says, فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ يَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ. Which of the two fariq, ayyuh, the ones who are committing shirk, billah, corrupting their souls, worshipping and wasting their time worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making andad, nid lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, making deities in likelihood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or disbelieving in Allah and His attributes and His names, or the ones who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ يَحَقُّ. So which of the two fariq, which of the two parties, the two groups, أَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ, has more right to safety? Allah says, أَلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, this is what comes out of, فَلْيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ, let them worship. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, that Allah will give them a yastakhlifanna, those eyes that we mentioned, let them worship. The result is that Allah saying that Tawheed brings about safety and security. This is what brings about, which is a direct message to those politically engaged youth who think safety, security, or leadership comes via challenging those in authority. Just picking up a weapon. La. بالصبر واليقين تنال الإمامة في الدين. With sabr, patience and yaqeen. And right now we have to do a tasfiyah wa tarbiyah. As Al-Albani used to mention a lot. Tasfiyah, cleaning, purifying, and a tarbiyah, cultivating the ummah. We have to get rid of all of the shirk and bid'ah and khurafat that are still crept into the ummah. You find Muslims, even in UK, believing in omens. Guys don't want to walk between two poles, bad luck. Cat crosses the road, bad luck. You find many of the Muslims in UK. Some people say, oh, Kitab al-Tawheed is not for our era. No, Kitab al-Tawheed is very relevant. You'll find cars that have things hanging at the back of their cars. It's called good luck charms. Or the one that looks like a web. A good luck charm, or whatever they call it, a dream snatcher or dream catcher or something like that. Or a fairy tale, like, you know, the tooth lady or whatever. All these khurafat wa khuza'balat. What is this superstition? You know, some parents, a'udhu billah, they scare their children to scare them and to make them do what they want. But they really, what they're doing is they're putting superstition and belief in omens to their kids. So Allah is mentioning Tawheed is the way. Allah Azza wa Jal said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who believe, وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ, and they don't pollute the iman with dhulm. Dhulm here, the ulama mentioned shirk, kufr. They don't pollute the iman with shirk. Ulaika lahumu al-amnu wa hum muhtadun. For them is amn, safety and security. So safety is security, my brothers and sisters. It's sought via glorifying Allah, the one who created safety and security, the one who has the best control and way of saving and security. Look at the Quraysh, they fled. They couldn't do nothing for themselves when they saw them elephants. But Allah stopped the elephants on their tracks, got rid of them for them. لِإِلَىٰ فِي قُرَيْشِ إِلَىٰ فِيهِمْ رِحْلَةَ الشِّتَاءِ وَالصَّيْفِ. نعم, فضل. نعم, Ibn Uthaymeen, he says, لِإِلَىٰ فِي قُرَيْشِ, he says, وَالْإِلَافُ بِمَعْنَى الْجَمْعَ والضم يراد به التجار التي كانوا يقومون بها مرة في الشتاء ومرة في الصيف. أما في الشتاء فيجتهدون نحو اليمن للمحصولات والزراعية فيه. He says, إلاف is جمع, is of something that's collected with ضم and to bring something together. And what is meant by it is the tujar, the tujar, the people who are basically the tradesmen who used to travel sometimes in winter, as we mentioned, and travel sometimes in the summer. And some of them, they used to actually travel نحو اليمن. They used to travel to go to Yemen. The ones who from أصحاب الفيل, where did they come from? They came from Yemen. لهدم الكعبة, right? To destroy the Kaaba. They came from Yemen. Some of them used to go to Yemen to get some, you know, some of fruits and vegetables and trade stuff like, you know, الزراعية. They used to go there في الشتاء, during winter, because it was good. It was good time for produce. وأما في الصيف فيجتهدون إلى الشام لأن غالب التجار فواكه غيرها تكون في هذا الوقت. As for during summer, they used to head to Sham, the lemon. Okay, you guys know where the lemon is, right? What does it consist of? What is the lemon? Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, Jordan, all that area. And they used to go them times to get their fruits because that was the best time for it. So على كل حال فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت. So therefore, Tawheed is meant to come out of this. Right? Tawheed is meant to come out of this. And that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is setting the stone and saying that if anything comes out of a punishment and reprimanding, then Allah Azza wa Jalla has already given us everything that we need, our lifespan, everything, so Tawheed should come out from that. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
وقل رب زدني علما.